And I'm back from my little break. So it is not really a sunny afternoon outside, but it's bright, and so I think that I'm ready to enter the Shale Bridge Cradle mission. Let's go and drop the cradle.
The Shale Bridge Cradle. It used to be an insane asylum, and before that, it was an orphanage. One night a fire started, no one knows how. And after that, they left the place abandoned. If there's a way to cram more misery into one building's history, I can't think of it. I'm here to learn about the old woman who attacked me in the Keeper compound. Drept said he saw the hag here at the orphanage long ago, when his childhood friend was murdered. He's never dared to come back, but I don't think I have much choice. It's a thin lead, but it's all I have left. I've never robbed an orphanage before, and I can't say I'm looking forward to this visit. There's no telling what I'll find inside. I'm used to the dark, but this feels like a house with bad dreams.
Indeed, I agree that the lead is extremely thin here. Let's have a look at the map. So it was an asylum, orphanage, and both things together, right? Sounds like a fun place. Anyway, we start here outside. Then we will roam around here in the front part of it. The passageway from the first half to the second half isn't marked on the map, but it's somewhere around here. Behind the storm cellar. Then I will go in here, empty the white hall, move along here, visit the morgue, and yeah, you will see what is going to happen, because you're actually quite guided in what you're doing in here. Not really a whole lot of freedom, but this doesn't change the fact that it's going to be a very interesting mission, and that I'm really going to be glad that it's not dark outside. Yeah, I'm just going to start now. Alright, and the dreadful feeling of fear is already creeping in. Just the first sight of it was enough to scare me already a little bit. Okay, there are some water arrows. Three. No, I'm not going to pretend anything here. The first half of the mission is without any foes again. But if you remember how I acted up in the Keeper compound, then this won't stop me from acting all scared and frightened. Not acting, actually being scared and frightened. It's a little bit different in here because there aren't really a whole lot of statues behind me from which I could be scared that I might creep behind me and attack me. Instead, there are sounds. The whole place is basically littered with notes left by two children. This here, yeah, it's just to give you the mood of the place. There are also other notes that indicate the treatment that they did to their patients here, which are horrifying in their own. If you actually understand what they are saying. I'm exploring a little bit, as long as I can manage, I think, before I'm going to start the second stage. The second stage, and I think that this will be very soon, because I just got scared by a stupid frigging dark light bulb. Okay. Yeah, what's this? As I said, there are also some notes about the patients. Not all of them, just certain some ones of these. This here would be the one with the stillborn child. She's carrying the ashes of a stillborn child around, and apparently she got into some sort of post what's the name for it? Postnatal depression? I think that is the name for it. Of course, this postnatal depression was even worse because the child was stillborn and burned, and yeah, this is why she was welcomed in this funny little institution here. Running around a bit and enjoying the fact that we now hear a baby crying. And I sort of hear footsteps in the background. I don't think that there actually are footsteps, but I'm hearing them. It will get worse. If I'm already getting scared by light bulbs, then I shouldn't linger here for long. The exit is still open. This is nice and good. I should really enter stage 2 because it's... I think it's a little bit dark now and I don't know how the video will turn up under these conditions. I thought that it may help me if I'm talking while playing, but it appears not to be the case. I'm still getting scared. So what have we here? This is a journal of one of the funny doctors. Let's call them doctors, even though they are more sort of torturers. This here is some sort of new I'm struggling because I don't want to call it therapy, but this is what they presented to be. This here would be heat application, you know, putting some sort of red hot iron onto naked skin to drive out excess moisture. There are footsteps. There are footsteps to be heard now. Or knocking. Yeah, this was special loot number 1, the vine of this pleasant guy here. Okay. Yeah, somebody's knocking around upstairs. I hope I didn't just say something nasty. I mean, somebody is knocking on the walls. I'm just taking this stuff here. Let's check out. Can I hold more than 5? No, I can't hold more than 5 bottles of oil. Also the full amount of health. I'm going to extend this stage now a bit longer than I usually would because I think it's funny when I'm getting all scaredy cat. Yeah, here's a funny apple. Oh my god! God damn it. I will just stay here now, and this will be a very extended episode because I don't dare to move now anymore. This apple here, which actually seems to have a green glow instead of the usual brown glow if I hover my mouse over it, is funny because it got programmed in the extra way that it moves and rolls around without settling down. Very entertaining. So, and a note, and I one note of the children. I didn't want to have my picture painted, but I was too scared to say no. I guess I did it right because I said good and still. There's another light bulb, and I know it. Oh yeah, I know that there's nothing here to fear. Really, there's nothing to fear, nothing to be afraid of. Nothing, absolutely nothing. I just save and